Hello guys, Shaden here. Before this video starts, I would like to issue a spoiler warning for Cobra Kai Season 5. I know this isn't my usual topic for videos, but Cobra Kai is my favorite show, and I felt it would be wrong if I didn't talk about it in some way. This show is the only show I've watched that I consistently love every episode. There are a few problems I would like to talk about in different videos, but for the first one, I want to focus on the positive. Kind of. My top 3 favorite fights in Cobra Kai and why. In the comments, please let me know some of your favorite fights from Cobra Kai. Number 3, the Season 2 Finale School Fight. Okay, roll it back real quick. Yes, I have the school fight in my third slot, but here's why. Of course, this is one of the best school fights in all of television history, but that's merely regarding the choreography. The artistic one-shots, the smooth Texas switches, are amazingly well put together considering the show was still on a YouTube Red budget at the time. But all good things have some cons, so here are my problems with the fight. The base of the conflict is built on the fact that Sam is a whore. By this point in the show, she's dated 3 guys, and she constantly bounces her feelings between Robbie and Miguel for the rest of the show. Tori has the right to be upset, but she isn't stupid. If she wanted to get back at Sam, she could have chosen a place and time outside of school. It wouldn't have had any repercussions. If she was planning to use weapons the whole time, then she wouldn't have needed all of Cobra Kai to back her up. In addition, we were given one of the cringiest lines in all the show during this fight.
She doesn't love you, she loves me! Yeah!
Secondly, Dimitri being able to defeat Hawk in any capacity at this point is astounding. Also, Dimitri being able to escape Hawk in a foot race is also astounding. Just like Hawk said, it was one lucky kick. If they wanted Dimitri to win the fight, I think it should have been by outsmarting Hawk in some way, not landing a lucky kick. Maybe ambush him when he walks through a door or trick him into running towards security guards. Either way, this conflict made no sense. Lastly, Miguel flipping from Tori to Sam so quickly is just overall cringy. 2 episodes ago, he was so down bad for Tori, and now he claims him and Sam are in love. What the hell? The choreography is masterful in this scene, but the plot should be just as important. Number 2, Chosen vs. Terry Silver. When I watched this fight for the first time, I was on the edge of my seat the entire time. This fight is without a doubt the standoff with the highest stakes in the entire show. Even when Chosen was drunk, he was able to best Terry in both hand-to-hand and weapons combat when he was wielding weapons of less range, versatility, and offensive capabilities. My only issue with this fight is that they reused the trope of getting distracted by a teammate to give the enemy the upper hand. The first time they did this was when Hawk won the All-Valley, but this time they did it to nerf Chosen and give Daniel the last laugh. It makes sense, but when the payoff of this is for the 60-year-old Ralph Macchio to do another cringy-looking crane kick, it was not entirely satisfying. Of course, this is just my opinion, and what happened with Chosen losing the fight was still a nail-biting experience. I generally thought the show was going to kill off Chosen here and have Kumiko's message from him be the last thing she ever heard from him, but luckily, he is hardly bothered by his injuries at all. Chosen was my favorite part of this season, and overall, it was satisfying to know that he is easily the strongest living fighter in the Cobra Kai universe. Number 1, Miguel Cafeteria Fight. No, I did not choose this fight because of choreography. Yes, it's good, but I chose this fight due to sentiment and what it means for Miguel. This is the moment we knew he would be a force to be reckoned with throughout the entire show, as well as showing the true power of Cobra Kai karate. Miguel was the first of many bullied kids to learn Cobra Kai and become more confident and powerful for it. Watching the latest season where Miguel was slightly sidelined, it briefly made me forget that the whole new generation of martial artists began with him. On top of representing the true power of a Cobra Kai transformation, it also gives parallels to Miyagi-Do, where the training finally pays off. This is Miguel's wax-on-wax-off moment, where, for the first time, he puts his muscle memory training to use and is astonished by the results. As a martial artist myself, I can attest to the fact that muscle memory and training helps a lot when in a fighting situation. I've been running the same drills for 12 years, and it helps when I go to tournaments a lot. This scene always gets me in a karate mood and motivates me to keep training. If you disagree with my picks, be sure to respectfully let me know in the comments. The next Cobra Kai video I want to do is more critical, so I'm hoping this one does well. Make sure to like and subscribe, and thanks for watching all the way through.